Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up some more examples in the concept of serializability, and we are going to take up some examples of tabular form, and we are going to discuss view serializability. So let's start with the first example. In any case, we have already discussed these two questions that I'm going to discuss in this session from the view of conflict serializability in the previous sessions. So in case you want to view them, you can directly check the previous videos. So let's start with view serializability concept. So in this case, I have the schedule with these three transactions over here, T1, T2, T3 executing concurrently. So first of all, what I'm going to do, the best method or the layout should be first to check for conflict serializability and then move on to view serializability. So when we checked for conflict serializability in the previous session, we got that it is non-serializable. Right, we got that it is non-serializable, and therefore we should check for view serializability. Right, so let's check for view serializability first of all. So how do we check for view serializability? We enlist these three operations corresponding to the three data items: initial read, update and final update. Let's check for initial read of A. Initial read means that it is reading the value of that data item from the database. So if I check data item A, I have read over here, and that's all, right? And since there is no write operation before this read operation, that means this value is directly being read from the database. The updated value is not being read anywhere. The value has not been updated also. So that means both the reads over here are initial read. So I'm going to list it as T1, T2. Now if we check for data item B, we have read B over here, read B over here, right? And there should be no write B before this in order to this to be an initial read. And since there is no write B before this, both of these are initial reads. So T3, T2, I've already written that, right? Similarly, if we check for data item C, we have only one read operation over here, and there is no write C before it. Therefore, this is an initial read, which is T2 over here. Then we write down the operation for update. Now what is an update operation? Update is a write operation basically. And we check that what are the transactions which are updating the values of these data items. So for A, we have only write A over here. That means only T1 is updating it. For B, we have only write B over here. That means only T2 is updating it. And for C, we have only WC over here. That means only T3 is updating it. Right, so that means what will happen? So that means we have written this update thing, and we'll check for the next operation. Now next operation is final update operation. Now since these are the only transactions which are updating them, so these will the only ones which will update them finally, because there is no other transaction which is updating these data items, right? So the final update will also be the same. Fine. So now let's check for the orders. So if I analyze this column of data item A, that would give me that T1, T2 are performing read and then T1 is performing the write operations. Now since the same transaction cannot violate the initial read of the same transaction, that means I do not have this conflict with these, right? So I just have to analyze this. So that means T2 will always come before T1 in order that the initial read of T2 should not be violated, right? So that means case of A, the order should be T2 and then T1, and T3 can come anywhere. That doesn't have a conflict with this. Then we analyze the column of B. If we analyze the column of B, we have T3, T2 and T2. So it is similar to the column of A. So that means the order will be T3 and then T2. Similarly, if I analyze the column of C, it says T2 and then T3. T2 and then T3, right? Now, if I compare the orders, now since I have to combine all these three orders, so if I compare these two orders, they do not have a problem. And if I would have to combine them, how would I combine them? I know that T3 should come before T2 and T2 should come before T1. T3 should come before T2 and T2 should come before T1, right? So the order is T3, T2, T1. But this is only if I combine A and B. Orders by A and B. But if I check the order of C also, what do I get to know? I get to know that both these two orders are conflicting with each other, right? So that means there is no serial order possible in this case. And the schedule is simply a non-serializable schedule with the concept of U-serializability also. So we will say that the schedule is non-U-serializable. So it was non-conflict serializable also. And since if a schedule is non-conflict serializable, we have to check for U-serializability, because a case may come, we'll also discuss that case in some future videos, when a schedule is non-conflict serializable, that is, it is proved non-serializable from the concept of conflict serializability, but it comes out to be a serializable schedule with this concept of view serializability, and then we finally label it as a serializable schedule, right? So in this case, it is simply a non-serializable schedule. Let's quickly move on to the next case we discussed in the previous session. So, in that schedule, what did I do? I just swapped the order of this WC from this to this, right? So, I've plotted this table. And let's just analyze the orders now. So, if I analyze this column A, I would get to know that this is T2 and then T1, T2 and then T1. And since the change has only been made in T3 and T1, right? I just swapped this operation from here to here. I just changed that order, right? So what will happen is the change will only be there in T3 and T1, right? So if I check this now, the column of B, if I analyze it, the order will be T3 and then T2, and from the column of C I would get T2 and then T1, right? Now if I combine the orders, I get to know, first of all, that the order given by A and C is same. So I can just take one of them, since they are representing the same thing. Let's just remove this for now. And if I have to combine these two orders, how would I combine them? It says T2 will come before T1 and T3 will come before T2. That means, again, T3 comes before T2 and then T2 comes before T1, right? T3 comes before T2 and then T2 comes before T1. So the order is T3, then T2 and then T1. Now in this case, we've been able to obtain a serial order, and therefore this schedule is a conflict serializable also, as discussed in the previous session, and it is also view serializable as proved in this session, and the order is T3, T2, T1. The same order we got in the previous session from conflict serializable method, right? So it also verifies our solution of conflict serializability. So I'm sure this would have given you a better clarity of the concept of both the serializability methods. Now, in case you have any doubt in any of the sessions related to the serializability or any of the videos posted by me, please feel free to post them as doubts in the comment section below. And in case you have any problems related to some other questions, you can also post them as comments in the section below. In case you like the video, please like it. Please keep following the channel for more upcoming videos and for more good work coming up. Thank you.